Hello friends, my name is Karun Nagpal and in this video I am going to talk about the corporate insolvency resolution process. In short, we will call it as a CIRP. So before that, let me give you a brief background of IBC. So Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code was enacted in 2016 with the endeavor to save the life of the companies in distress. So it is not merely a recovery legislation like SARFAESI and recovery of debt due from banks. And the primary focus of IBC is to ensure revival and continuation of the company as a going concern. So it empowers the creditor of the company with the assistance of IPs to bring them out of the insolvency-like situation and continue the company as a going concern. So let us start with the corporate insolvency resolution process. What triggers the CIRP? So it is a default. So once the default is there, an application can be filed to NCLT. So NCLT may accept or reject the application once admitted. Moratorium will be declared and IRP will be appointed. He will make the public announcement and COC will be constituted. Meetings of COC will happen. IRP will get confirmed as an RP. Management of affairs by RP and information memorandum is prepared by the RP. Then preparation of resolution plans by the resolution applicants. So those plans will get presented to the committee of creditors. They approve the plan and then will submit that to NCLT. NCLT will review the plans and in case accepted, the insolvency will get resolved. So in case of rejection, the liquidation order is passed by the NCLT. So this is the brief process, CIRP process. So we will discuss each and every aspect of this process in detail one by one. So let us first start with the default. What is default? IBC defines default as non-payment of debt when it has actually become due. So non-payment when it is due. So default has to be more than 1 lakh rupees for initiation of CIRP. Some other important terms before we proceed with the process. So I would be using these terms during my presentation. So let us understand them. Corporate debtor. Corporate debtor here is a person who is under insolvency. It is a company. Financial creditor. A person who to whom debt against consideration for time value of money is due. So these includes banks, financial institutions who have lent money to the corporate debtor. This also include home buyers as well. So this got amended later on after the Supreme Court judgment in IBC. So home buyers are considered as financial creditors. Then operational creditors are those to whom debt in respect of provision of goods or services is due. So these are those company with which corporate debtor normally deals with during the normal course of business, and employees are also covered under this category of operational creditors. Information memorandum is a document which contains all the material details of the corporate debtor, which is prepared by the resolution professional. Resolution plan is something that is presented by the resolution applicant and on the basis of information memorandum. And resolution applicant is someone who is trying to resolve the insolvency of corporate debtor. So it is some other company who infuse money or some kind of restructuring is done to resolve the insolvency of corporate debtor. We understand the default and we also understand financial and operational creditors. So let us now understand who can approach to NCLT and file an application and who cannot file the application to NCLT and what is the process of filing application to NCLT. So either financial creditor, a single creditor or a group of creditor can approach to NCLT and file an application. Operational creditor can also approach and file application to NCLT. Even the corporate debtor, in case it is insolvent and it has committed a default, it can approach to NCLT and file an application through its shareholders or person in charge. So who cannot make an application to NCLT? So corporate debtor who is undergoing CIRP process cannot file application to other debtors, other companies. Otherwise, it will result in a chain reaction and all companies will fall into this process of CIRP. Corporate debtor who have completed CIRP 12 months preceding the date of making application can also not file application to NCLT. Corporate debtor or financial creditor who has violated any of the terms of resolution plan approved before 12 months or even corporate debtor who is into liquidation cannot file an application for CIRP. So now let us talk about application to NCLT by financial creditor under Section 7, how to file this application. So financial creditor submits an application along with a fee of 25,000 and shall obtain the written consent from the person who is willing to act as an IRP. NCLT reviews the application and confirm the defaults. So in case everything is okay, NCLT will accept the application and send a copy to the corporate debtor. So before acceptance, it will issue show cause notice to the corporate debtor as well to provide the reason why this application should not be accepted. And in case the application is defective, it gives 7-day time to the applicant, here financial creditor, to rectify the defects. When can application get rejected by NCLT? So it may be due to the disciplinary proceedings pending against the resolution professional, or default cannot be established, or in case application is incomplete and could not be rectified within 7 days, so it may get rejected by NCLT. Now the application can also be filed by operational creditor under Section 9. So here the fees is 2000 rupees. And before filing the application under Section 9, a demand notice has to be issued under Section 8 to the corporate debtor by operational creditor. So NCLT here reviews the application, confirms the default. Application has to be accompanied by the demand notice, the invoice, copy of invoice. And in case everything is in order, it will pass an order for admission of application. In case defective, give 7-day time to rectify the defect. So once accepted, send a copy to the corporate debtor by registered or speed post. So in case of demand notice issued by the operational creditor, the corporate debtor may, if the payment has already been made, provide the proof of payment, pay the balance outstanding amount and then furnish the details, or provide the evidence that the amount is in dispute. So in case disputed matter, application cannot be filed under this code. Application can also be filed by a corporate debtor under Section 10. So again, the payment fees to be made, fees is 25,000, and along with the application, some other documents such as books of accounts and the proof of default, its inability to pay, the special resolution passed by the shareholders with 3/4 majority. All these documents to be attached along with the application, and NCLT will, if everything is in order, it will accept the application. And in case of incomplete application or any disciplinary proceeding is pending against IRP, it will provide 7 days for resubmission after rectification. So what will happen once the application gets accepted by NCLT? So after the acceptance, NCLT will declare the moratorium and IRP will get appointed and he will make the public announcement. So let us understand what is moratorium. Once the application is accepted under section 7, 9 or 10, its adjudicating authority here in case of corporates, it is NCLT. So it will declare the moratorium, appoint an IRP and cause a public announcement which will be made by the IRP. What is moratorium? So this code provides a calm period during which all the proceedings for recovery will come to a halt, and adjudicating authority will pass an order prohibiting transfer of CD's assets, foreclosure, recovery. Everything will come to a halt. All the proceedings will stay as it is, and the supply of essential services such as electricity, water, IT services, telecom shall not be terminated. So what is the purpose of public announcement now? So public announcement is to be made by IRP to make aware the general public about the CIRP process of this corporate debtor and to collate all the claims from different creditors. So it shall be immediately done by the IRP within 3 days of his appointment. And in one English and one regional language newspaper, and is also displayed at the website of corporate debtor and the website designated by IBBI. And it also mentioned that the proof of claims shall be submitted within 14 days of his appointment. After the public announcement, all the creditors of the corporate debtor will be aware of the CIRP process in respect of the corporate debtor, and they will submit the claims, and on the basis of claims, COC, Committee of Creditor, will get constituted, and there will be meeting of Committee of Creditor which IRP has to conduct, and the Committee of Creditor in its first meeting will either affirm the appointment of IRP as an RP or may appoint some other RP to take care of the rest of the process. And then RP shall manage the rest of the process. So constitution of committee of creditors. So IRP shall collate all the claims against the CD, and then on the basis of claims, he will constitute the committee of creditor. So who will constitute the committee of creditor? All financial creditor, excluding the financial creditor who are related party to the corporate debtor, will constitute the committee of creditor. What in case there are no financial creditor? So in case of no financial creditor, 18 largest operational creditor by value and one representative from employee and one representative from workmen shall constitute the committee of creditor. Appointment of resolution professional by COC. So COC with a majority of 66% either resolve to appoint the existing IRP as an RP or replace the IRP by another RP, and the RP shall manage the rest of the affairs of the CD. Appointment, RP will manage the affairs of CD, and he will prepare the information memorandum. So that is one of the tasks he will perform as an IP. So what are the roles and responsibility of RP and IRP? I have shared separate video on that. And let's talk about information memorandum, what it contains and what it is. So information memorandum shall contain the detail of assets and liabilities of the corporate debtor, the latest financial statements of the corporate debtor, audited statement for past 2 years, all the related party transactions, detail of any guarantees, and detail of shareholders with their shareholding, material litigations, detail of employee and workmen and their dues. And this document has to be given to the prospective resolution applicant so that they can come up with the resolution plan. And they have to sign the confidentiality agreement wherein they will say that they will protect the intellectual property of CD and will not share this information to the third party. So after having all the relevant information about the CD, resolution applicant can prepare the resolution plan. So they will come up some kind of resolution plan, and that RP will present to the COC, And COC will decide whether to go with the resolution plan, and they will choose among the best resolution plan available with them. So, preparation of resolution plan by the resolution applicant, and then that plans get presented in the meeting of committee of creditor. So, how this plan gets presented? So, resolution applicant come up with the resolution plan along with a affidavit stating that he is eligible under section 29A talks about ineligibility of the resolution applicant. So, they will give the resolution plan to the resolution professional, and he will present that plan to the COC. So, once he examined that it is viable and it comply with all the regulations of IBC, and the committee with a vote share of not less than 66% will decide whether they are willing to go with this plan or not. So, once the plan is approved, then the plan will get submitted to NCLT, and NCLT will decide whether the plan is as per law or not. So let's see what can be the probable scenario. So in case non-submission within the due date of this CIRP process, so IP can approach to NCLT and seek extension. So he can seek extension for 90 days. So, non-submission within the due date, no extension is allowed, then company will definitely go into liquidation. NCLT has to pass the liquidation order. Submission of plan and is approved by NCLT, then the insolvency process get resolved. So in case plan is submitted and is rejected by NCLT as it is not meeting the criteria or is not as per the law, then NCLT will pass liquidation order after expiry of CIRP process due date, 180 days plus 90 days extension. I hope you would be able to understand the CIRP process by watching this video. So what will happen if the resolution plan will not get accepted by COC or gets rejected by NCLT? So the liquidation comes, CD will go into liquidation, and how liquidation process works, what are the different stakeholders in liquidation, what is the role of liquidator, IP will function as a liquidator there. So I have shared another video on liquidation. Please do watch them, and thank you for watching.